Well, good morning, Victory Church. We would like to welcome you to this morning's Church with a Twist. We've got 5 videos lined up for you this morning. In our first video, it's going to be on the couch. We're going to be hearing from Jono and his mom, Lol. They're going to be updating us with what's been happening in church life this week. And Jono's got a very special request for each of us as well.
Welcome to church. Yeah, it's so good to have you guys with us. We're on the couch with Jono and Lol this morning. Those who don't know, Lol lives with us in the flat, and it's so great to have you with us. Lol, yay, on the couch.
Good morning, everybody.
Yeah, so good to have you. Just a quick shout out to Evie. Happy birthday, Eve.
Happy birthday to Eve Holloway. Hope it's a great day. We love you lots. We're missing seeing your beautiful face, but we know that you're going to be celebrated lots. Send her a message. Send her a birthday message. We love Eve.
So I was just thinking the other day, so lockdowns, certain things happen, as in you need to cut your own hair. So I had myself cutting my hair the other day. I don't know what you guys think.
That's good.
Good.
I even cut my hair.
There we go. So I was also thinking back to, I'm sure you used to cut my hair back in the day.
Sure.
I can sort of remember the old bowl
thing on there.
So just a quick little, who had their mom or someone in their family back in the day when you were young? Hands up if they cut your hair. We would love to see some shocking pictures if you've got. Send them to us. That would be fun to maybe have a look at. So that is so good. Plus, just in some of our Zoom chats in this week, we had a prayer time together. The band guys, we had a Zoom catch up. The youth guys, there were some dodgy haircuts, some dodgy beards going on. Guys, we need to clean up. Look after yourselves in lockdown. You need to sort yourself out. Chezzy was looking great. Joshy Cross, you need to sort that head and beard art, mate. It's not looking good. Anyway, so our theme for this year is make the circle bigger. Now, if you're sitting back and you're thinking, well, jeepers, we're in lockdown, how do we do that? Let me encourage you. It is so important for people to feel loved and connected during this time. So can you look after 3 people? Can you phone 3 people? Encourage them, phone them, chat, see how they're doing. What do they need? Can you pray with them? 3 people, can I challenge you? 3 people, ask them to do the same thing, and in that way we can make the circle bigger, we can reach out, we can advance the kingdom during this time. It's so important. So if we can do that, let me challenge you. 3 people. So yeah, we're on the couch with Lol this morning, and we've asked her just to come and share a little bit about her thoughts as to what is happening. So Lol, all yours.
Over to me.
Yes.
We are living in such unusual times. I think nobody in this generation has experienced anything like this, where you can't even go out your gate or walk down the road with the possibility of somebody questioning you, yeah. Where are you going, should you be out, and what are you doing? And so we all are in uncharted territory and anxious. I'm sure everybody is a bit anxious deep down, some more so than others. And this is the time when, and we also sort of wondering what is going to happen next. Mm. What's going to happen when we come out of lockdown?
Yeah.
Is this thing going to come back? Is it going to be gone forever? And so on. So we've all got these deep down anxieties. But you know, we've got God, and that makes such a difference for us, isn't it? So if people without God, I don't know how they can cope. But I came across this verse in Deuteronomy 31 verse 6, and it says, be strong and courageous, do not be afraid or terrified because of them, for the Lord your God goes with you, he will never leave you nor forsake you. And that's those words were spoken to Joshua by Moses, and he was commissioning him, because you know, Moses didn't actually enter into the promised land. And then later on, when Moses died, the Lord said to Moses that it's to Joshua that it's now time to go and to go into the promised land. And he said that he would go before them, but it was handed over to Joshua to lead this group. And then again, that same promise, have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous, do not be terrified, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. And so I think we must use this time that we've got now, where we are locked down, we've got time on our hands, and don't let's waste this time. Let's use it
yeah.
to spend time with the Lord. Let's use it to get into the Word and to read the Word. Take a book, one of the books, and read right through it. Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians. It's just so motivating to read through those scriptures. Read through Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John and get the whole story of Jesus. And so let's make use of this time. It's so important that we do that. We need to also spend time in prayer. This is a time when we can make a prayer list and just be praying for so many people, so many out there who've lost their jobs, so many people who food is running low yeah. or have no food. And pray for our church family, for the body, and just we need to be praying. And I think it's also a good time to just to sit and be still. The Word says, be still and know that yeah. I am God. He is still in control. This hasn't taken him by surprise. So he is in control. And then I think it's so important for us to stand on his promises, like this one that we've got here. And I also like the scripture, actually, if we go back a bit, it says, do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. And it comes with a condition. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. So God has got us in his hands, and yeah. he's promised that he will go before us and that he will never leave us nor forsake us. I just wanted to finish with reading, because we need to stand and be strong. And so I want to read from Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 17. And it says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of the dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, you still stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with a breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests.
Yep.
With this in mind, be alert. Always keep on praying for all the saints.
God. That is fantastic. And while my mom was just kind of reading through stuff, it was so great just to look at her Bible and just to be encouraged again that we have got a wealth of knowledge and wisdom in our older generation. It's so great having a multi-generational church, and we're so blessed to be able to have that. And so let me encourage you again, get on the line. If you've got people in your world, in your life, that have got great wisdom, have got, look at all these. I mean, there's notes. This Bible has been done for years and years and years. It's been around. So I just want to encourage you, learn from those wise words as we're in these uncharted times that we're in. Be encouraged. Have a fantastic rest of the service. Have a great Sunday. And we'll see you again soon.
Enjoy your Sunday. Bye.
In our second video of the morning, we're going to hear from the Holloway family. They're going to be sharing with us their tithing and offering journey in their lives.
Good morning, everyone. We'd like to show you a quick video clip taken in one of the townships around Cape Town in this lockdown period. And it's just incredible to see how an attitude of gratitude can change your perspective. Enjoy.
My name is Nomvula Ben. My church is Joshua Generation Danone. So I'm going to give you a tour of my house. So come and follow me. You can come in. So this basically, this is my house. And that is my kitchen over there. This is my kitchen. You can see my fridge. And this is my bedroom. So you can see I sleep there. My girl sleeps there. And then this is our lounge where we chill. As small as it is, it's actually big. I can invite people here, ladies from church, they dwell here and we worship here, we pray in this house and we have fellowship together. It's so cool. We thank God for this house.
And how many people stay here?
That is me and my three daughters and my grandson. So this is so cool. Oh, a toilet, you've got a toilet here. But now for now, we close this door and we're going around and use the toilet that side. The door is on the other side.
And is there hot water here?
No, we don't have hot water. We boil hot water using the kettle there or the stove. And here also, this is our bathroom. This is where we bath. Yeah, this.
Where's your bathroom?
We use this. This is our bathroom. This is our bath. You can see we take water and then we put it here and then we... We bath.
And where's the shower?
No, we don't shower. We don't shower, we just use the bath. We just get inside here and put water here and then you bath.
And where's the garden, Vula?
Our garden, I've got a small garden over garden. Here. Mm. This is my small garden here. This is my small garden over here. And this is my study as well.
It's a nice study, eh?
It's a nice study. Yeah, this is my study, yes.
Hey, thank you for the tour, Bula. God bless.
Thank you, guys. I want to say to everyone who is, like, really worried, I want to encourage you guys, like, do not worry. Like, God provides, and He really does. And even for me, like, personally, like, I'm a single mother, but God, I never slept without food in my house. Like, God provide like crazy. Like, really, I trust God, and I don't depend on my salary. I depend from God's hand. I eat from His hand. So I want to encourage, like, do not worry. God's economy is always good. It's always, like, He never... his economy doesn't go down, never. It will never go down. He's always God. So just be strong and trust in God. He will provide for you. Even if He doesn't, He's God. He knows what He's doing. He's got what is best in His heart for us. He loves us so much. All we need to do is to trust Him. Man, I'm amazed, for He knows what we need before we even ask Him.
We don't rely on man. We don't rely on salaries. We rely on God. He's our source. And in these trying economic times, it's so easy to put your eyes on man. But I want to encourage you guys to keep your eyes on God. And He knows what you need before you even ask. Isn't that incredible? We want to encourage you to carry on giving in this time. There'll be some links just below this video on our webpage if you want to do an EFT or a SnapScan payment.
Have you been wondering how Victory Church has been serving the community over this period, the last 4 weeks or so? In our third video of the morning, we're going to be showing you just how we as a church have been getting involved and serving our community.
Hello everybody! Going good. We're on about 9 hours 30, so I just have 3 hours to go. I don't know about the maths.
Hello, I'm Kelly and I am going to tell you about my 12 hour 38 minute run around my garden. The idea came about when I was reading Matthew 19:19, says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. And I thought, funny coincidence, that's a lot of 19s and COVID-19. But I started feeling quite helpless about, well, how do I feed the hungry and love my neighbor if I can't give very much financially and it's lockdown. So I decided to run and raise funds for Food Forward SA. And on Saturday, I did it. I jogged for 12 hours, 38 minutes, and eventually 62 kilometers. People were driving past and hooting and cheering, and had my neighbors supporting over the wall. And I've managed to raise over 18,000 rand for Food Forward SA, and I am overwhelmed by how God has used my little ability, or my stint of crazy, to make a really big difference. So I want to encourage you that if you're feeling helpless and that you can't share a lot of love in this time, God wants to use you as that loaf of bread and multiply your act of love.
Our fourth video of the morning is going to be a time of praise and worship. As a family, we'd like to go into a time of praise and worship together, and the Weber family has put together a list of songs for us to do just that.
Before we enter into a time of worship this morning, I just want to share a few thoughts with you. And I'm going to start just by reading from Matthew 22, verse 37. It says, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind." This week, I've been challenged to just love on him. In these interesting times, we're coming to him with all our requests, which is good. He wants us to lean on him, and we should be doing all those things. We should be entering into spiritual warfare. We should be praying for the sick. We should be praying for healing, and we should be reaching out to our neighbors and praying for those who don't know him, praying for revival. But we should also just be spending time loving him. And this week I heard a line from a pop song that says, "I forgot to love you." And I was really challenged in that, am I spending enough time just loving him in this crazy time? And so I would encourage you now in this time of worship to just forget about your distractions, forget about that it might be awkward worshiping in your home, and just do what you would normally do in church. Close your eyes, stand, and just enter into a special time with him, and just love on him. So Father, we pray now that as we enter into worship this morning, Lord, that there will be such a connection with you, and that we can just love you this morning, and that we can just be still before you and just spend some time reconnecting with you, Lord. We pray this in your precious name. Amen.